Okay, so first we create a new empty activity. Let's name this application sort array list. We select Java for the language and leave API 15 as minimum API level. First of all, let's deal with the layout. We can use this existing text view. It is already aligned to the middle of the layout. We'll change width to 0 dp. Now the text view stretches to fill the screen. We delete the hello world text so nothing is displayed. Now add a new class. Right click new Java class and name it item. We add three fields to the class. ID of type int, price of type int, and name of type string. We add two constructors, alt insert and select constructor, and select none to add the default constructor. Hit again alt insert and select all fields. Then we add the getters and setters. Again, alt insert, select getter and setter. Select all fields again. Lastly, we override the toString method. Alt insert toString and select all of the fields again. Now we go to main activity. We declare the text view variable. Alt enter to import the text view class. Create a new list of items. I'll name it my list and write new array list of items. Alt enter to import the list and array list classes. Let's add some item objects. I will intentionally spread the ID, price and names in a no order. For the first time item I write 2 for ID 20 and item, and we add the item to the list by writing my list add and the item as parameter. The second item object will have 5 for ID, 30 for price, and item 3 for the name. So again, the items are not in order on purpose. By the end of this video, we will program the way to sort the list by ID, price, and by name. Add the second item to the list. Copy the last two lines. By selecting them and hit Ctrl D to duplicate those lines. Duplicate one more time. We have four items added now. Let's make this object to be of ID 3, price 60, and name item 1. And duplicate one last time. This item will have ID 4, price 50, and name item 4. Then we create a function that prints all the items. We'll name it showList generate the method. Name. Let's traverse the whole list of items with a for each loop. And we'll append each item to the my text. We call the toString method of each item class. The toString shows the ID, price, and the name of the item. And we add two new line expressions. So that there is enough space between the two items displayed. Now we can test to see what we get so far. Remember, up to this point, the list is not sorted yet. Looks like we have an error. Let's see what we get. So we forgot to initialize the myText view. To point to the text view in the layout. The text view doesn't have an ID yet, we'll add an ID of my text. In the main activity, we reference it by rid.myTxt. Now it should run correctly. As you can see, the list is shown in the same order as the items were added. To sort the array, we need to implement the comparable or comparator interfaces. First, we'll implement the comparable interface. Write implements comparable and give it a type of item. Alt enter to implement the compareTo method. CompareTo method, we need to compare current object's ID to the ID of the object that is passed as the parameter of the compareTo function. If the current ID of the current objects is bigger than the parameter's object's ID, we return 1. Otherwise, we return -1. And 0 if the IDs are equal. So this will allow us to list in an ascending order starting from the smallest ID to the biggest. To sort, we add collections.sort and add my list as parameter of the method. The sorting is done before the list is printed, before the showList method. Let's test this in the emulator. You can see that the list is sorted by ID in ascending order. Now to sort in descending order, we add the collections reverse order as the second parameter. Of the sort method. Now you can see that the list is sorted in descending order by ID. Now you can implement sorting by price and by name. We had a public static class name by price, which implements the comparator of items interface. Enter to implement the compare method of the interface. We rename the parameter names so that they sound more intuitive. Since we are comparing by price, which is of type integer, we can do the same comparison as in the compareTo method above. If item price 1 is bigger than item 2 price, then the return 1, otherwise we return minus 1. And 0 if the two values are equal. To test, we go back to main activity and in the collection sort line. We replace the second parameter to be new item dot by price. So that the sorting is done by price, now you can see that the sorting is done by the price in ascending order. The last thing to do is to implement the comparison by name. Copy the by price class and paste it as a new public static class. We only need to change the return line. Since now we are comparing two text values, we write item1.name compare to, and we pass item2.name as a parameter. We also need to change the name of the class to by name. And we are all set. Change the second parameter of the sort method to new item by name and test it. Now you see that the ID and the price are not in order, but the name fields are in ascending order. Item 1, item 2, item 3, item 4, and item 5. Hopefully this was helpful. Leave your questions and comments in the comment section below. See you next time. Thank you and bye.